like Beatles in the city. Be back immediately to confiscate the money.
Fresh girl. Wow. My will.
You sent flowers, but you said you didn't receive.
But you said Mike, you didn't need.
That girl is a real crowd please. Small world, all the friends know of me. Young bull living like an old king. Quick release the cash, watch it fall slowly. Frat girl still trying to get in. Haters mad for whatever reason. Smoke in the air, they lose it when the DJ drops the knee. Getting so cold, I'm not blinking. What in the world was I thinking? New day, new money to be made. There is nothing to explain.
I'm black, needle cream seats in the Regal, rocking John Lennon lenses, like to see them spread eagle. Love and let a party on the table, screaming everybody's famous.
Like clockwork, I blow it all. Then get some more. Get you somebody that can do both. Like Beatles got the babes belly rolling. She thinks she love me, I think she trolling. That girl is a real crowd please. Small world, all her friends know of me. Young bull living like an old king. Quick release the cash, watch it fall.
Good morning, OJR. It's Thanksgiving time, a time to be thankful for everything we've been given.
And a time to get ready for Christmas.
Come on, Gretch. Thanksgiving hasn't even passed yet. We have to focus on the holiday at hand.
Fine, fine. Let's just get this over with then. First, we have an announcement from student government. Everyone come on out to the first Lip Sync Battle on December 2nd at 7 p.m. Tickets will be $5. Come on out to see your favorite students and staff lip syncing their hearts out. We can't wait to see what all the contestants have prepared. We hope to see you there.
Thanksgiving is a holiday full of historical goodness. Student Undercover takes a break from her normal antics to bring us this quick bit of knowledge.
Student Undercover here to uncover the history of Thanksgiving. Let's go.
When was the first Thanksgiving?
Oh, good God.
After dinosaurs and before the Pythagorean theorem.
I have no clue.
1982, the Pilgrims had their first Thanksgiving stew.
1982.
Wait, I have an important question. It's really important.
How you doing?
Who was the first pilgrim to sit down at the Thanksgiving table?
Me.
Right.
Right.
Wrong.
Scott Pilgrim?
Charlie Brown.
Close enough. Where are the Pilgrims living now?
They're dead.
Plymouth?
Lancaster.
Yeah.
It wasn't about the people that were there or even the food that they ate. It was about the history that took place. This was Student Undercover. I'm out.
Thanks for the education, Miss Undercover. As Tyler said, Thanksgiving is all about being thankful. For example, I'm thankful for Christmas.
Gretchen.
Sorry. Anyways, now we go to Brittany Dell'Aquila to find out what everyone is thankful for.
Hey OJR, Brittany Dell'Aquila here. In honor of Thanksgiving, I'm here to see what our faculty and students are thankful for Thanksgiving. So let's go.
So what are you thankful for?
I'm thankful for my family and that I'm safe.
My sister Casey.
For food and for avocados.
For my mom.
Football.
For my wonderful students and my newly born daughter.
For the grateful Sean Barone and his compression socks.
Life.
What's that? You're thankful for me? Thank you!
Oh, all the great artists in this school, they're amazing.
Family, friends, and teaching at a wonderful school like O&J Roberts.
I think she's thankful for this skeleton over here. Is that right?
Yes.
I'm thankful for my friends and my family and working at a great place like O&J.
There you have it, OJR. Everybody's thankful for something for this Thanksgiving. I'm thankful that I can get into college. This has been Brittany Dell'Aquila reporting for the Paul Report.
Thank you for that fine segment, Brittany. If Thanksgiving is known for anything, it's the food.
And Christmas.
Get out of here. Anyway, we're going to teach you the most crucial part of Thanksgiving, preparing the turkey. It's Thanksgiving, guys. So do you know what that means? It's turkey time. So here we are, Tyler Paul, Gretchen Harkin, to show you how to make the best turkey dinner you've ever had.
Turkey time, turkey time. You know it's turkey time, turkey time.
So, for ingredients, tell them what we need, Gretch.
All you need is some chives.
Right.
One potato.
One.
Some Mediterranean sea salt.
Mediterranean.
Believe it or not, a fortune cookie.
We need to be blessed.
And a bag of oil.
I will ask that if you have a weak stomach, you look away. Now that turkey's dead, you're gonna put your turkey in the pot.
Just like that.
Now, patata, right? You take your patata and you throw it in the pot, okay? Now, you take your oil. Now this is where it gets a little...
messy.
You remove your nice watch that you bought. You remove that first. And you take your hand, you put it in the oil, and now you realize that oil's not grabbable. So then you pour the oil on the chicken. The turkey will make noises because it likes to be lathered, okay, ladies and gentlemen? The turkey likes to be lathered. Now, mama always taught me that you need to tenderize your meat. What you do is you smack it around a little bit, okay, back in the pot. Now you have oily hands. So you go and ask Gretchen to get you a napkin. Now you take your chivis. You take your chivis, and you get a little... You take your sea salt, fresh out the Mediterranean.
That's perfect.
Okay. Excuse me, what's gonna happen in this turkey's future? We need to know. You take your fortune cookie, you read your fortune. You will be surrounded by luxury. And you coach your turkey. So, you know, turk is a little too long, so we gotta cover him up a little bit.
Okay, there you go. Okay, now the most important part of this is we are not going to cook Mr. Turk in the oven. We're going to put him in the microwave.
Oh. Yeah.
For 4 hours. Because microwaves are the future.
Later.
Okay, 4 hours later.
Ah, you might want to pull it out with the glove.
And bingo, there's your turkey.
Well, OJR, we hope you have enjoyed this Thanksgiving special of the Paw Report.
We hope you eat some good food with your family, but most importantly, don't forget what you are thankful for.
Have a great weekend, OJR.